All right, y'all, so we are actually leaving off the base right now. I don't want to record. I don't know if I can or not. I don't know what a military base looks like, right? Passing the dorms right now, I'll give you like a little itty bitty taste, but those are like the dorms and everything. But yeah, we're leaving, getting ready to hit the road. And I don't know, I guess I'll recap once I get home. All right, y'all, this is the area where Gabriel is at. I had to get this on camera because it's like one of the highest points, but you can see like everything. Look at it, it's beautiful actually. But it's basically like a wooded area. All right, y'all, we are finally home. It is, what time is it? I'm safe and sound, no issues at all. The crazy thing is, when we left the military base, the check engine light on the van was off, like random. Ava and I are back safe and sound. We got a lot to do between now and the next few days with like just cleaning and getting things back in order, because we kind of left out in a hurry this morning. But anyway, so I saw this restaurant called the Redneck Barbecue Lab, and y'all know me, I'm gonna try anything once. Look at this. So we got barbecue, we have cornbread, and we got coleslaw, and then they gave us these three sauces. Competition barbecue. Okay, so barbecue, and then smoky black pepper, tangy sweet, and then NC pork sauce. Y'all, it's been a long day. I'm tired, and I have to work tomorrow. I didn't really get everything that I wanted to get done over these last like 4 days, but it's all good. I'm gonna keep pushing anyway. Today, honestly, it was really quick. Like everything happened really, really fast. We've never been to this place before, unlike Tar Heel Challenge Academy where we went there. We were actually a little bit late today. I told you we were running behind this morning, but it was fine. There was actually like 9 people that had not arrived. Actually, I heard the lady say, but anyway, we got there. There's like this big room there where like parents and kids were sitting down at. And if you had additional paperwork to fill out, you filled that out. If not, basically like say your goodbyes. We got a picture together. Yeah, that was it. They took them out. We walked with them outside, and there were like other students. I don't know, what do they call them? Are they cadets?
Yeah, cadets.
Yeah, I think they're still cadets. Some of the other cadets were outside as well. So they took the cadets away in like groups, basically. So we walked outside with Gabe after I filled out all of my paperwork. The group that he was in was with one of his friends from TCA. So I was kind of happy about that. I was like, okay, he won't be by himself. I know, which is weird, but whatever. Yeah, they loaded up the van. They had like this white van. They were putting like all the kids' bags and stuff in. Oh, we did end up having to stop. We had to turn it. We were on our way to the base and we had to turn around because we forgot to get laundry detergent. So we found a Dollar General, I believe it was, and got some laundry detergent for Gabriel. But yeah, it was really quick. We probably spent a total of like 20 minutes there at the base. Like, I took a picture of him, and that was it. That was pretty much it. I did not realize that Gabriel is gonna be doing some like indoor air jumping. Like, what do you call it, Ava? Indoor skydiving. So we had to sign like this like release form, and then Gabe had to sign it also. But I was like, oh my God, I'm so jealous. He gets to do indoor skydiving. Now that's gonna have to be on my list for this year, to do indoor skydiving. We thought about it. We were gonna do it, what, last year or year before last? That's definitely on my little to-do list. Yeah, he'll be there until May 6th, but he will have, I believe, 2 home visits. So he'll get a chance to come home. I wanna say sometime in February, and then maybe again in either March or April. I can't remember, but I've got it written down somewhere. But yeah, he'll have a couple of home visits, and yeah, it's pretty much like TCA, but it's like more, it's like an actual military base. So like the barracks that they are staying in are like actual barracks. Like, you know what I mean? Like, it's more TCA, I feel like, was like the precursor to life in the military. And Job Challenge is like, it's pretty much like basic training, I feel like, kind of, sort of. Except they're like, you know, they're working on a skill, or they're doing extra work to get credits. So in any case, I'm excited for him. I'm happy for him. I do miss him. Like, honestly, I walked into the house And I was like, oh, I kind of miss him. But yeah, I'm happy that he's getting a chance to experience like all of these things, you know, because I feel like that's
stupidest thing happened today, right?
So we're leaving the military base. Mind you, I have been on a military base before, but I don't think I was the one driving. So I think maybe that was the difference. But as we're leaving the military base, and I was trying to figure out like how to get out, and I'm like trying to like follow the arrows and everything. And we get to like where I think that I'm going out at, and there's like these spikes sticking up out of the ground, and I'm like, wait, I can't go over that, like that's gonna mess up my tire. So I'm looking for the guy that was there at the gate earlier, and then there's this car, like two cars pull up behind me and they stop, and then eventually the lady like pulls her car from around my van and like goes around me, and she's looking at me, and then I watch her like drive over what I thought were spikes, but they went down. And I just felt so freaking stupid. Like, how did I not know this? Yeah, that was kind of embarrassing. I was like, oh my God, I feel like an idiot right now. This is why I'm happy that Gabriel is having these experiences, honestly, like just life experiences. I want both of my kids to just be able to experience things and not feel like so left behind, you know, so they don't feel like complete idiots when they're almost 40. Oh my god, anyway, I'm gonna eat my barbecue. Actually, I'm going downstairs. I'm upstairs now. I was gonna sit in bed and eat, but you said it was what time?
It is currently 6:37.
Yeah, it's too early for me to go to bed. It's not even 7 o'clock yet, so I'm gonna go back downstairs. I'm actually watching The Durrells in Corfu. It's a British series. You guys probably haven't even heard of it, but it's a British series. It's about a single mom from Britain that left Britain and moved with her four kids to Corfu, which is an island in Greece. And yeah, she like basically started a new life there. So it's like about all their adventures and whatnot. And of course, it mirrors my life. And I found this movie actually when we were living in the shelter. I started watching it there and just like completely fell in love with it. So I'm watching it, rewatching it now for probably like the third time. The third time maybe, but it's really good. It's really good. I love it. And there's like a whole book series on everything. So anyway, that is it for tonight, guys. I'm gonna cut this video short so I can go downstairs and eat my barbecue and watch my TV before I go to bed and get ready for work tomorrow. I will keep you guys updated. Anyway, I'll see you guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.